Hello YouTube, and welcome back to another episode of Explain That Game, the series that showcases a game and most of its features to help you decide if it's worth your time and money. Today, we are looking at Treasure Adventure Game by Robbit Studios. Pretty uninventive title, but we'll carry on. It's available completely free through the official site and through GOG or GOG, whatever you want to call it. GOG is actually one of my favourite digital distributors. They're committed to providing everything DRM free, and they like to add extras to their games, like concept art and stuff. It's a really good company, and when you make an account, there's a few other free games you can get. Mainly they distribute old games, but they're getting into doing newer stuff now. It's actually a sister company of CD Projekt, the same people that made The Witcher and The Witcher 2. So, yeah. I personally think you should check them out, but you don't have to. Yes, if you want to support the game, because it did take 2 years to develop and has been released as freeware, which is pretty amazing, you can donate on the official website or buy the original soundtrack on Bandcamp, because it's awesome. The game itself is a side-scrolling Metroidvania-style game with puzzle elements, so that's RPG, all that kind of stuff, except you don't level up, but you do find new items, so perhaps not Metroidvania, but you get where I'm coming from. Been doing a lot of these sorts of games lately, actually. The story. The area the game is set in used to be a giant continent until a wizard battled and defeated a demon using 12 artifacts of power, and that shattered the continent into many smaller islands. The game starts with a flashback of you, your father, and a researcher entering a temple that these magic artifacts are supposed to open. It's unclear what happens after that, but next you're being taken care of by an old woman on some island somewhere. Okay, so that's the information out of the way. Now onto the menus. Now all the options aren't available here. You do have to run an external client to change the resolutions and the controls and stuff. The external client gives you access to the game size. It's not technically a resolution option. It's either ×1, ×2, ×3, ×4 or full screen, and that's just essentially how big the game is on the screen. There's VSync, key bindings, there we go, key bindings, and controller support. I do recommend running that before you run the game. You'll probably need to run it as administrator, as with the game, otherwise it'll crash or won't do its job. Because it doesn't actually list the controls in game, which is the weird bit. So if I go down to this menu here, I'm using my NES pad again, or my Famicom pad to be more precise. That's actually something that I forgot to mention. This game is very temperamental, especially with fraps running. It will crash every time it tries to load something. That's with fraps running. So if I try and enter a new area or something. So this video is going to be a bit ghetto, unfortunately. I'm going to have to keep stopping and starting the recording when I'm going to new screens. This is the control screen. It actually just says jump button, attack button, action button, so you need to know what those are. So it really is recommended that you run that external launcher first. Right, so we'll go over to the actual game now, to the save system. So this is what you get when you press play. You get three save slots. I have actually started that one. That's the save slot that we're going to start with, and this is the one I've been playing 16% of the game. And it has been quite enjoyable so far, but I'm not sure I'll be able to get further because of a crash. I'll probably try and figure that out later. It might just be my setup. Okay, so we'll load this one. This is your sort of starting house in the main area. This is a save point here. You just press up on it, it saves it. Unfortunately, you don't get to pick which slot it goes into, which is a little bit annoying. Mainly for me trying to record the video, because I like to have saves prepared of different areas. So I've had to record this a little weirdly. Movement, as you'd expect, left, right, jump. You can also crawl, which allows you to fit through smaller gaps. And there's an attack, where you swing your hand, because you've got a hook for a hand, if you didn't notice. Now, we have been told to collect a map from our grandma. Well, we haven't been told to collect a map, but that's what we're actually getting. We've been told to visit our mother, our grandmother before we go. Although she's not actually our grandmother, but yeah, we'll go see her, grab the map, do what she wants, and then I'll cut over to some lighter gameplay so you can see what that's like. Come on, woman. Give me the thing. The map. There we go. It's the one. Now, hopefully this won't crash the game collecting this. It didn't? Yes. An item that I was... I don't know what these are. I think it'll let you teleport between islands later, but I can't as of yet. First thing you're actually given in the game is a boat, which will automatically appear whenever you touch water and will come back to you whenever you touch land. So that's quite handy. It gets a sail and stuff later, but you'll see that. And if we go here, you can enter all these buildings and make the game crash because you forget you've got fraps running. Okay, so yeah, this particular one's just a toilet. Probably not much point in coming in here, to be honest. So where do we want to go? You can talk to people, by the way. There's kind of a light bit of There's a light bit of puzzling that you can actually do here. If I take us inside this house a sec. You can see that we climb up here. It's got a guy watching TV, being a bit of a... sounds like a bit of a prune. You can see there's a little red chest right at the top there. And now we can't get to that from inside. So, the way to get it is we go back outside. You should be able to hear the soundtrack as well. I did leave the music a little louder than normal because it's, I really do like it. You can use these as little hooks to climb up. And then, I'm going to have to pause Fraps to jump down the chimney. But you'll see it anyway. And then we're up here and we can open the chest and get much, much money. And everybody loves money. From what I can tell so far, money in the game is only used to buy hats. Which is a little strange. The hats don't actually increase stats or anything like that. Because the game doesn't actually have stats. But you'll see that. Ooh, I nearly forgot. This is one of the cooler things that you can do in the game. And this comes up a lot. You can cling onto sides of ledges with your hook hand as well. Which is pretty cool in my opinion. We'll go in this shop actually while we're here. Now this is one of the hats that you can buy. We unfortunately can't afford it at the moment. Yeah, he doesn't know what it's called, a baseball hat. I assume baseball doesn't exist in this fictional world. No, you can't help me find anything. Go away. I'll take you into here because you'll be able to see some of the combat. I wonder how many times I'm going to crash the game in this video. Something that I did actually forget to mention earlier is that the world does have a full day and night cycle, and people are outside doing different things at different times of the day. Shops close at a certain time, the backgrounds all change. It's really quite detailed how they've done it. This is actually something that encourages you to revisit the area later. This sand here you can't get through at the moment, but you find a shovel later which will allow you to dig. So that's what this is here for. Okay, now most of the enemies follow similar AI. They just try and run into you or just run a certain route. Bosses are obviously different, and I'll show you one of those later. But for now, let's just kill this guy. One and two. You can see my health and money in the top left hand corner there. I should have more than that, but because I crashed, I lost the money from that chest I gathered earlier. The platforming feels really quite smooth as well. Right, now here's where we use our crawling. You can also climb up passages that are about that that thin, but vertically as well. Okay, and we've found the old man that we were looking for. And we'll show him the map. Oh, did I not get the map? I almost forgot to get the map on this side, but essentially he'd just send us somewhere else. And that's kind of how the story progresses. You get maps, and then you follow them to all different places. I did actually just crash the game again. Okay, so this is actually on my later save now, and this will let me show you something that I didn't earlier. If we bring up the menu, you can see that I've actually got a range of different items. There's the bird, which if we talk to him... you need to be outside to talk to him, so let's just go out this door here. Okay, right, so we're actually in a massive tree at the moment. Yep. See, there we are, we can talk to the parrot and he'll give us a clue on what our objective is supposed to be. Okay, yeah, bring this menu back up. You can see we've got a selection of hats. The only use I've actually found for a hat so far is that wearing a purple hat, which is my awesome pimping top hat, actually scares some enemies off and they'll turn their back on you, making them easier to kill. I've got a compass, which actually gives me directions from a map. So you see I've got that map selected here. And if I take this off now, you see I've got an arrow in the top right hand corner screen. I always get those mixed up, top right and top left when I'm recording videos, I don't know why. But yeah, in the top right hand corner of the screen I've got an arrow pointing me to the location of that map, which is quite a handy little feature. There was something I forgot to show you back in here too. You can see that there's an exclamation mark above this and it does mean that it's a quest, but this actually isn't a main quest, it's sort of a side quest, because this green stuff is making all the animals sick. So if you talk to him, he'll talk about getting medicine, so trying to find that medicine is actually a sub objective. You never have to do it. I haven't so far because I just haven't stumbled across it. Now if we go up here, there's actually a mechanic that I do want to show. This mushroom was never actually wasn't there originally. Mushrooms will often grow in certain places to make getting back there easier. If you've already done it, that is. Let's see if we can get up here. If you hear any mewing, it's because my cat's in my room. Okay, we're nearly there at what I want to show you. We'll put my top hat on because it's more pimping. There we are. And just make our way over here to this little platform. Now this is a puzzle that I've already solved, so I'm actually going to unsolve it for the purposes of the video. You can control the parrot when you're on those particular particular platforms and use him to do certain things. So originally, this was actually impassable and the rock was here. So if we just grab this rock now, and we're essentially just going to move it back. I just thought it was an interesting mechanic, using the parrot to solve various puzzles and things. None of the puzzles in the game so far have been particularly hard. If the parrot does get hit, he just returns to you. So sometimes it's actually quicker to do that after you've finished a quest than going through the whole thing again. Oh, dear. So I think now I'm actually gonna get ready to finish up the video, and I'm gonna cut over to the future of some boss footage. And the boss was actually quite hard because I've already filmed the boss footage, and he killed me a couple of times, but it was quite good. So yeah, I'll leave you with that. Okay, and here we are back with possibly the last thing I want to show you. This is the first boss fight I've found just through that door there. I've had to do some puzzles and stuff to get here, like one that involves sliding blocks and you had to stop it from being destroyed by exploding enemies. It's a little long-winded, but overall quite fun. So yeah, we're going to do this fight. I believe I get one of the objects I'm looking for, although I don't think it was the one marked on my map. I could be wrong there though. So yeah, we'll just go through here. Okay, so that's the boss there, that pile of rubble, and that thing on top is the item that we're looking for. He's actually pretty tough and I've died a few times, unfortunately, because the loading thing that I mentioned earlier, the game crashes every time I die with fraps running. So as well as me dying, I have to restart the game. That's all kinds of humiliation. Ooh, and he does so much damage if he actually hits. So I'm gonna have to really try and concentrate here. There we are, that's one hit. Doing well. So that if you roll in the middle when he brings his hand down, you just cannot run out of life fast enough. I did originally think that was impossible to dodge though, so you know. That's how you know a game's good, when it makes you think that something's impossible, but then you later figure out how to do it. Oh, what a... Oh, I missed the jump, didn't I? I'm such a pleb. I better die now. That'd be so typical. I'm actually hoping he catapults me up to his eye, but something tells me that's not going to happen. Two hits. This is the best I've done so far. So I might have him. Let's hope he does the video game three hits. Well, I've often noticed bosses take four hits. There we are. Ooh, nearly got spiked. Ooh, I might as well didn't get spiked then. Oh, it's 1-0 down, so one hit on, more hit on the other, I guess, so it's the video game 4. And we've actually got quite a bit of health left, so it's good, it's very good. Oh, come on, son. Yes! Take that, bitch. He was tough, he was. He must have killed me 3 or 4 times before I beat him. I think it's just because you move quite a lot slower than he attacks. When you get the hang of him, he's alright. And he's got a save point outside, so that's not too bad. Let's see if we can get this item then. Aha, here we are. Is it one of the 12? I got a treasure. Cool. Does it do anything, or is it... Orb of Revelation. It looks like it may just be a collectible. Unfortunately, the game is crashing for me at the end there of that boss, if I have fraps running or not. It's a little bit unfortunate. I don't know if it's just my setup that's doing it. So the game's still well worth the go. But I'm going to end the video there. I would have liked to have actually seen if the treasure did anything, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't. It just seems to be that you need to get all 12 of them, which makes sense. I mean, that's the plot, isn't it? And you find other items such as the shovel, which give you abilities throughout the game. So, this has been Harvey from Who Knows Gaming. If you've enjoyed this video, if it's helped you out, leave a like and or subscribe. If you didn't, then don't. Goodbye.